What is the best HEMA mask on the market 2022 at this moment? I don't know, but I know one of the heaviest I'm going to review is the Uhlmann Historical Fencing Mask Special. And this mask had some unique features that most masks do not have, or only a small amount of masks have, that I will talk about in this video. Overall, the characteristics of this mask. This mask is a normal 1600 newton mask with a 1600 newton bib, of course, and 1000 mesh, if I can recall. So nothing all too special. It's stainless steel, RVS in our language. You do not need the overlay padding. You do need the back of the head protection that is included in it. It does include the back of the head protection that you can add to this mask, and you can also add the overlay. Put it rightly like this. But you do not have to need to use the overlay. The mask has removable inner padding with klittenband. I don't know the English word for it. The inner padding has some unique features that it has holes to the ears, to the side of your ears, so you can hear better in it. And it's a more expensive mask on the market. It is around 300 euros. You can order it at Uhlmann and at in Motu. The shipping time is on the website. It says it's like 3 to 5 days on Motu, but both the times me and one of my clubmates ordered it, it took 1 month or more than 1 month. So that you have to take in mind if you order it, that the shipping date can take a little bit longer than it says. Most of the reasoning is because Motu has to order it at Uhlmann, so it has to go from Uhlmann to them to me. So that was one of the reasons that it took longer than expected. But yeah, take that in mind. The overall measurements. The mask is a little bit longer and a little bit deeper than other masks on some parts. The bib is around 13 centimeters, and from the chin to the back of the head, so from the circle to the back of the head, is like 18 centimeters. It mostly is 4 centimeters longer than most masks, so you have a bit of your head can stuck a little bit more in, like the back of the head needs to be. But that's still a problem because I have some issues with the back of the head, more later. Shortly, I cannot, it does not fit. All too politely, so the weight, the full weight of the mask, so with the back of the head, with the mask, with the overlay, is 2490 grams, and without the overlay it's 2114 grams, and without the overlay and the back of the head it's 855 grams. So overall it's more of the heavier kind of masks on the market, so take that in mind. So the mesh, the top and the front, and the talking about the thing, so it the metal plate, talking about that, the mesh is just normal like other HEMA masks. It has some special features on the chin, on the side front of your head, and on the top of your head. It has metal plates that prevent dents on that part of the masks. So it's pretty heavily armored against strike against your head. But it has some small problems. It's not more fortified than a normal mask if you talk about thrusts. It has some dents here and here. And the most concerning part is one dent around here that has gone because of the plates, has come under the plates and has become stuck here, so it dented in at this place. That's because there is a small space you can put your nails in between these gaps, so your sword can get stuck on those parts. That's really not a nice thing to see. I only have this mask since September 2021, so only 4 months. But if I have any more updates, huge updates, I will talk about it. Or if anybody else in the comments can say their experience with the mask, please do. It will be very helpful to find out how much worth is this mask, because 200 euros is 2 times a normal HEMA fencing mask. So, talking about the side of the mask, the side has some raised padding. So normally it goes, it stops here with most masks, but here it's extended to more the eyes height of your of yourself. Also, like I said, it's longer, so also the bib is extended more to the back. So also take in mind that the bib, where we will talk about after this, is connected also to the back of the head, to the, not to the back of the head, but to the, to that side. There is one problem with the side of the head. When you do not use an overlay, according to Daniel Over Sutter, the side of the head can get damaged and this fabric can get loose. The rivets pop out and you have to glue it back together, and then it works, but you have to take that in mind that it's not you don't have to use the overlay, but it has some downsides to not use the overlay. I also have some upsides to not use the overlay. Most it is less weight and less heat stays inside of the mask, because it can escape from the top, the sides, much more easily. The bib. It's longer, like I said, 13 centimeters, and most masks like the PBT are like 9, and the Red Dragon masks are like 8.5. So it's quite more bigger than the previous masks I had. Just 1600 newtons. It has one downside. I tried this mask on with an arsenal jacket, and because of the way the arsenal jacket is built and the way this mask is built, it's sliding against each other, and because of that, with wearing an arsenal jacket, you cannot move your head proper enough to really look from left or right when you use an do not use that jacket. You do not have the problem with an spes jacket, but with an arsenal jacket I have noticed that it's a bit more problematic. Also, Olivier also used an arsenal jacket in combination with his mask, and he said it's becoming more or less problematic over time when sweating in, when using it, and then it's more doable and more a preferred combination than when you start with it. The back. It has a mesh back of the head protection. It really helps against strikes to the back of your head. Also, the back of the head protection also is also the back of the head protection is a real help for that. But I have some downside about it. When used in combination with the back of the head, in included back of the head protection, I have noticed that the back of the head protector has some downsides to it. When wore with this mask, almost everybody that has bought this mask, that's around 5 people, have the problem that it's very hard to put over the chin, and it is even more hard to get it off. It's not comfortable at all. In the beginning it does not even work at all with me. One clubmate still does not use this back of the head protection because he finds it too uncomfortable and not working at all. You know, it is not possible, in his words, last time we spoke. So that's a real problem about this mask. It's really protective, but it is a pain for in the ass for your chin. Also, if you look here, my chin is tearing out the inner padding. So that's that's not no. So talking about the inner padding, we already talked about this, about how it got over my chin and it's tearing apart. That's a thing, but it's removable, it's washable. That's our really good upsides. It has a earpiece that very an hole at the ears that you can hear better. I found that very nice to have. Because it's washable, it's also a very good thing to know that when I tried it on with an overlay, it got very sweaty very quickly. I will try out if it's different with not wearing the overlay, but still, in comparison with other masks I tried, it's a downside. So that was most of the part about the mask. I will now go to the conclusions. So the conclusion about the mask, is it worth 300 euros? I will talk about the upsides and downsides. So the pros about this mask, it's one of the heaviest, as in armor, as in getting hit, getting the strikes upon it. It's one of the heaviest masks that you can buy at this moment on the market. It's specialized around strikes, not against rust, but it's not lesser than other masks, I suppose. It has an excellent stiff structure, also a downside, so it's very stiff. So if you get a strike on the side of your head, it does not get dented in on the side. So the impact is covered to... It also means that if you want to resize it, like normally you press it against in between your thighs and you try to deform it to your liking, it's very hard to do that, and that's because of this plate. It stops it from happening. Also, to stay in shape, and because it is a heavier mask, it does not bend very well. So it's an upside and a downside, I suppose. You probably can use it longer than other masks. So for 300 euros, how long will it last? That's really the question. Only had it since September 2021. So how long will it last? Upsides is that removable inner padding, and that was it. To other masks, it has more so side, bigger bib, more protection on the bib. Included own back of the head protector, but the back of the head protector is shit in combination with this thing. I have tried it without back of the head protection, and then it's just easy on and off, no problem. But this back of the head protector, no, it's very... So yeah, let's go in melee to the downsides. Back of the head protector is a downside. First weeks when you use this, it did not fit at all. I had to use my old spes overlay protection when using this. Also, one of the heaviest masks on the market in when you talk about weight. So it's 2490 grams. It gets sweaty very quickly. Problems with the awesome jacket. So the awesome jacket is not the nicest combination when using this mask, because you cannot move your head very well. I do not own that jacket, but I have tried it out in combination with the mask. Also, the fabric can get loose when not used with an overlay. It got loose within a few sparring bouts with the masks of Olivier Sutter and Jonas. He used glue to get it back together, and I found out the downside. But when he used glue, it did not get loose again. So that's a thing. I will say it's probably not worth two times the same mask. Nah, not the same mask, but a HEMA fencing mask that is like on 150. So I would recommend this. So yeah. Is this the heaviest HEMA mask on the market at this moment? Yes, it is. Also the best HEMA mask on the market at this moment, if I can say so. And I will call out the competitors. So you have the famous rear guard or arming guild mask. And that one is not purchasable at this moment. I have tried to back order it, but it's almost more than a year. It is a year ago since I ordered it, and it's still not in my possession. They have a problem with the factory. But it the rear guard mask also has one smaller plate on front, and also has a more extended to the back of the head, and also has mesh to the back of the head. Different shape. They are flat, and this one is curved back of the head. Also an included back of the head protection, as they also have. It is 200 euros, around 200 euros, maybe something more, 250. And you can say they say they have more inner padding than any other mask. So that is also a thing about the rear guard. Talking about PBT Warrior. PBT Warrior only has, in combination of this, has an extended back to the back of the head. And it's also one of the heavier masks. Also around 1800 grams on its own. So without overlay and back of the head protection. That's only a few less than this one. And this one has extended, and also this, and also this, and also this. And yeah, so. All-Star, you can also not purchase it at this moment. A mask that is more pricey than this one, 325 euros. It has vertical bars that protects the front of your face against strikes. I've never seen a review online, so and they also do not tell much more about it. You cannot order at this moment, so yeah. So that are the competitors at this moment. So when you take that in conclusion, is this the best fencing mask at this moment, 2022? HEMA fencing mask? I would say yes, but probably not worth two times 150 a normal mask. But we have to see that. I only had them for a short time, and I will try them out. So thank you for watching, and goodbye.